Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In today's class, let us discuss sections of solids. Here we are taking the solid is pentagonal pyramid. So let us take this is the example of the pentagonal pyramid. It has one base, it is in the form of pentagon. Okay, this pentagon and here one point, it is called apex. This pentagon and apex are connected with the help of what type of face it is? Triangular face. Okay, and now here each side of the base we can call it as base side, okay, and then this height we are calling axis. Okay, axis is nothing but we are joining the center of this pentagon. I am taking O here, O to apex. This is the apex with the imaginary line. Okay, it is called axis. The distance between center to apex is known as height of the pyramid. So this is called axis, height of the pyramid. Initially take the given data, after that we will see the projections. Here let us take a pentagonal pyramid of base side 30 mm. Just now I told each side of the base is same length, it is 30 mm given value. Just write down 30 here. And axis 60 mm. Axis means height of the pyramid, it is 60. Is resting on its base on the HP. HP means horizontal plane. So base is resting on HP. So here I have given the position of the solid, given solid. Okay. So base is resting on HP, whatever data they have given, I have written here. Okay, this base we are keeping on the horizontal plane. Okay, let us take this is the horizontal plane. We are keeping the solid like this. Base is on HP. Okay, and next data is with a side of base parallel to VP. VP means vertical plane. Okay, same thing I have written here. Side of the base parallel to VP. And also given nearer to it. That side is nearer to the vertical plane. Okay, now what is the meaning of it? Here this is the base side, any one of the side, it is parallel to the vertical plane. Okay, let us take this is the vertical plane we are keeping here. Okay, so vertical means it is making 90 degrees to the horizontal plane. This angle is 90. This is a horizontal plane, this is a vertical plane. Now this side of the base, any one of the side, it is parallel to vertical plane. So if you are taking this gap, it is constant. Okay, we can call this side is parallel to the vertical plane and nearer to the vertical plane. Okay, if I am keeping the side is like this, okay, side is perpendicular to vertical plane here, but he has given side of the base is parallel to VP like this. Okay, pentagon position is like this and nearer to it, this side is nearer to the vertical plane like this. This is the position of the solid given. Okay, here we have to do the projections of the solid. Projections means front view of the solid, top view of the solid. Initially we have to do the top view of the solid. Top view of the solid means we have to see from top. We can see the pentagon like this. Okay, below XY. So initially we have to do the XY line of any length. We have to do the polygon initially. The pentagon side is parallel to VP. Okay, it is coming like this. So we have to do the pentagon like this. Correct? Now this is the top view. Now after that we have to do the front view. We have to see from front. We can see the front view, okay, on the vertical plane. Front view is we can see the entire height. Okay, this triangular faces we can see in the front side. So forgetting it, just do the projector lines. So what is the height of this pyramid? It has given 60 mm. So take 60 mm height here. We can see the slant edges. Okay, like this. Roughly I am doing here. Okay, we can see the front view like this, top view like this. Okay, after that, what is the given data? So this is the position of the solid. Okay, after that, it is cut by a section plane parallel to the VP. VP means vertical plane. Okay, the same thing I have written here, cutting plane position, it is parallel to VP and 12 mm in front of the axis of the pyramid. Same thing I have written here. Okay, the pyramid position is like this, correct? This side is parallel to VP and the cutting plane is, this cutting plane is parallel to VP. Is a cutting plane. The distance between axis and cutting plane, distance 12 mm. It is cutting the solid like this. Okay. So this part, the cutting plane is removing. Okay. Now this is the position of the cutting plane. Okay. So in it, what we have to do? Draw its sectional front view on top view. After cutting the solid, how the front view is looking? We have to do the sectional front view as well as we have to do the top view. After cutting it, how the top view is looking? we have to do these two views. Here I have written we have to do sectional front view and top view. For doing these two views, essentially we have to do the solid projections. The solid is pentagonal pyramid. Projections means front view and top view. First we have to do this diagram without cutting plane. Okay, here I have written all the given data. In the sheet, no need to write all the given data. No need to do these problems. Directly you have to do the projections by using the drawing instruments. Okay, so let us do these projections. Let us do first initially this pentagon. Here we have one formula for doing the pentagon. We are using the outer angle formula. This angle is outer angle. Okay, now here what is outer angle formula? 360 by n. N is number of sides of the pentagon. Okay, 5. The angle is 72 degrees. If you are cancelling this, we are getting the 72. Now at all corners, outer angle is same. So this angle is also outer angle. It is also 72. Now if you are extending this, this angle is called outer angle. Outer angle means outside the diagram. Okay, it is 72. Now if you are doing here, it is also 72 degrees. Okay, at all corners, outer angle is 72. Let us do this pentagon. First do the XY line of some length. After that, this gap has not given, we can take any gap. After that, do this side of the pentagon. What is the side of the pentagon? 3 cm. Just do one 3 cm line. After that, take this 72 degrees angles. Now take 3 cm this side, 3 cm this side. Let us do the pentagon initially. Here initially I will do the XY line. Here give some gap for marking the height of the pyramid. Just take XY line, that is reference line of some length. Mark XY. Okay, here do the line after some gap, 3 cm line. Take this is the reference line. Here do one line of some length. On it, mark 3 cm. Take 72 this side, 72 this side angle. Here 70, 72 here, one point. Here also take 72. 70, 71, 72. In this direction, take 3 cm. In this direction also, 3 cm. Here take 72. Here also take 72. So take 3 cm. Now this is a closing side. Check whether this is 3 cm or not. No, it is exactly 3 cm. Join these two ends. So here we got the pentagon. Give the names for it. For top view, we are giving small letters. Here I am taking small a, b, c, d, e. Now in the top view, we can see this pentagon. Okay, just now we did. Now as well as in the top view, we can see in the top view, we can see the slant edges also. Okay, all slant edges are meeting at the center of the pentagon. Okay, so if you see from top, you can see the slant edges also. All slant edges are meeting at the apex. This apex and this center, both are coming at center of this pentagon. Okay, now find how to find center of any polygon. It is symmetrical about vertical axis. Okay, so center is coming on the vertical middle line. Okay, now we have to take, for finding center of any polygon, we have to take any two adjacent sides. We have to do the perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector means, let us take, we are taking these two sides, adjacent sides. Okay, one perpendicular bisector will come here. Okay, one line is coming here. The perpendicular bisector means that line is dividing this BC into two equal divisions and also perpendicular to this line. And here also we are getting one more line. The intersection of two lines will give the center of any polygon. Okay, here as we know, we are getting the center on the vertical middle line, okay, which is passing through this corner. Just do one line here and take this side, do the perpendicular bisector. So this line and this line intersection point is center. Okay. Here what I am doing, do the perpendicular bisector for this BC. We have one process of doing perpendicular bisector. Take any radius with compass. Okay, this radius is more than half of the length of BC. Half means approximately here, this length. More than half I am taking. Do one arc this side and one more arc this side. Okay, take the same radius, C as center, cut this arc. Okay, join these two points, you will get one perpendicular bisector. So this is 3 cm, as we know, mark the middle point, that is 1.5 cm. Okay, join B point to this middle point like this. Now this line and perpendicular bisector intersection point is the center of this pentagon or base. I am taking it is O, and apex is also coinciding with it in the top view. Okay, O comma O1 I am taking. We can see the slant edges. So in the top view we can see the slant edges also. Okay, all are meeting at the center or apex. So join all the corners to the center. This is the top view. Let us do the front view. Okay, front view means in this direction we are seeing. We can see the entire these triangular faces. Okay, we can see the entire height. Okay, what is the height of this pyramid means 60 mm. Okay, so initially do the projectile lines here. This projectile line should be in light color and perpendicular to XY. From all these corners, we will do the projectile lines. Take this vertical line is a reference line and move the scale. Do the projectile line. In the top view we are taking small a. In the front view we are marking a dash. This is a dash. This point is b dash. And the center is also coming o dash comma b dash. Okay. And then this point is d dash. This point is c dash. After that, take the height of the pyramid. Just now I told it is 6 cm. So take the continuous line, 6 cm line. Mark the end point, do the line. Okay, join all these points to this point. It is the apex. I am taking O1 dash. For front views, we are marking dash. Okay. Now join A2 O1 dash. Now here E and D are invisible points. So if you are taking in the front view, these two sides we can't see from the front side. Okay. So whatever lines are passing through it, these edges are invisible. So for invisible lines, we are doing with dotted line. Join E2 O1 with dotted line. Doing the projections, take the cutting plane position. Plane is parallel to VP. This is the vertical plane. So this is the position of the cutting plane. Okay, so here in the top view we can see the pentagon and we can see the cutting plane parallel to the vertical plane. Okay, now let us do the cutting plane position. Okay, this gap is, as we know, 12 mm from the center. So here mark the cutting plane. So from center take 12 mm dish gap, that is 1.2 cm. Okay, so cutting plane is passing through this point. Okay, this gap is 12 mm. Now as you know, cutting plane is parallel to VP means here we are getting one line. Okay, so like this we are getting one line at this point. Okay, this is looking like line in the top view. For getting the parallel line, take this is a reference line by using rule scale. At this point do the cutting plane. Okay, cutting plane we are doing two big lines with a dot like this. Okay, mark the end names for this cutting plane, HT. Okay, this cutting plane is cutting this part. Make this part in light color. This cutting plane is intersecting the solid at three points. Here one point, here one point, here one point. Mark the names of those points. We can take any alphabet. Here I am taking P point. Here I am taking Q point. Here I am taking R. Okay, at these three points, it is cutting the solid. Okay. And now mark these points in the front view also. Okay. So for getting it, just at P and R, and if you do the projector lines. Okay, so projector line means thin lines. Okay, let us do at P point. Take this line is the reference line, move the scale up to B, do the projector line. It is touching at XY line at one point. So here in the top view we are marking small p, in the front view we are marking p dash. Okay, now similarly at R also do the projector line. Take this is the reference. At R, do the line. Take this is R dash. Okay. Similarly, at Q also, we have to do the projector line. But here, we can't do the projector line. It is already on the axis line. Okay. Points, for the axis points, we have to take this length by using compass. Okay. Whatever this radius, just take that radius up to this OC. okay, edge. This arc is touching at this point. Mark this point is M, small m. Okay, very small m on OC. Now take the projectile line up to OC, slant edge. Okay, small m is on OC. Take the projectile line up to OC. Take this is a reference line. At M, do the projector line up to OC. Okay, this intersection point is M dash. In top view we are marking M, in front view we are marking M dash. Just do the projector line, horizontal projector line up to this axis line. So take this is a reference line. At M dash, do the projector line on this axis. Whatever point is coming here, instead of Q in the front view, we are marking Q dash. We have marked P, Q, R here. P dash, Q dash, R dash. Okay. Join all these points. I am joining P dash, Q dash by using scale. Join Q dash, R dash. Here we are getting the hashed section. Okay. This corner we are removing. Okay. So it is looking like triangle. Make this should be hashed one. Hashed one means we have to take this area 45 degree slice. At one point I am taking 45 degrees angle. Now here we will get 45 degrees line. Just for taking the reference line. Okay. Take this line as a reference. Move the scale in this area. Make into hashed lines. Now here this is the sectional front view. Okay, and then top view is this part is the top view. Okay, we have to take the remaining part should be in light color because we are removing this part. And mark the given dimension. Side length of the pentagon is 30 mm and this cutting plane position is 12 mm from the axis and height of the pyramid is 60 mm. The other lectures of sections of solids, video links I will give in the description box. Please check it. If you like this lecture, hit the like button, subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.